Students, so now set R to 0, what happens? Similarly, this slide shows two NAND gate, NAND latch, that is NAND using latch. So here we are using two input S and R. S will be 1. S will be 1 means the output will be 1. That is set state. So according to the truth table and excitation table, S will be 1 means that is set state. Set state means the Q will be 1. Q bar will be 0. So in first NAND gate, the Q bar will be given, given to the input of the next second input. So in that condition, the input of the first NAND gate will be 0 1. 0 and 1 means according to the truth table that will be 1. So in second NAND gate, so one input is R, so that will be 0. So second input of the second gate is Q. So here Q will be 1. So what will be the input of second NAND gate? 1 0. 1 0 means the output will be 1 according to the NAND gate truth table. So here now set R to 0, what happens? The state flip back, Q is reset state. If R is 0 means is a reset state. So here we are using two NAND gate. S will be 1, the R will be 0. S will be given to the input of the first NAND gate and 0 will be, R will be 0, so that will be given to the input of the second NAND gate. So reset state means that is 0 state. So the output of the first NAND gate will be Q, so that will be 1, which will be given to the input of the second NAND gate. And output of the second NAND gate will be given to the input of the first NAND gate. So what is the output? 0 transition 1, 1 transition 0. Finally, set R is 1, what happens? In that slide, finally, S will be 0, R to 1. What happens? So S will be 1. 2 NAND latch we are using. R is 1 and Q will be 0. So because this output, input of the second NAND gate is 0, 1. 0, 1 will be given to the second AND gate means, so that will be Q bar. So Q bar is given to the input of the first NAND gate, so that will be 0. So S R 1 1, the output will be Q and Q bar. So 0 transition 1, here 1 transition 0. So here R to 1, what happens? Q and Q's, Q bar do not change state. So in that slide, R will be 1, S will be 1. S will be 1 means set state. S will be 1 means the output of the first AND gate will be, sorry, NAND gate will be 0. That is Q bar will be 0. So that is 0 transition 1. R will be 1. Again Q will be 1. 1 means the Q bar will be 0. That is 1 transition 0. So this is timing diagram representation. S, R, Q, Q bar. S means high to low state, R means high state, Q means low state, and Q bar is transition state. So in that timing diagram representation, small delay in response in Q and Q bar. That is called transition state. S will be same, R will be same, and there is a time delay response in Q and Q bar. So here, when S returns to high, both Q and Q bar remain in the same state. So S will be high state and R will be high state, and Q and Q will be remain in the same state. So here Q and Q bar will be a small delay. S will be the same state, R will be in the next state. Q and Q bar will be in small delay. So this timing diagram representation, Q and Q bar flip-flop state, that is flip state. Q will be flip state and Q bar will be a high flip, and Q bar will be a low flip state and Q will be a high flip state. So here S, R, Q, Q bar, here also S will be a set and reset state and R will be a high state. Q and Q will be the low transition state and high transition state. So in this timing diagram representation, so S, R will be the same state. So there is a small delay in S. Similarly, there is a small delay change in Q and Q bar. Next is latches. So here provide us with a simple form of memory state of a critical circuit. Depends not only on current inputs but also on the recent history of inputs. But our circuit responds anytime the inputs are low. We want to limit the state change to a very narrow time period. So this will allow us to synchronize the state change of several devices. So these are the latches. So next class we discussed flip-flops. So flip-flops, we have so many types, and that will be discussed in next class.